empirical data, and you would be surprised to know that, you know, there are many tasks of PMSA, and one out of these one task is to, you know, combat poaching or illegal fishing in our waters. And based on empirical data, we found out that every year the Indian fishing boats which cross the maritime boundary and come into this Indus Delta for fishing, they rob us of $10 to $12 billion of fish. This is based on empirical data, the hold of, you know, the average size of fishing boat. But this is the damage in terms of monetary value. But the damage in terms of, you know, marine ecosystem, which they do by bottom trawling and all other using, you know, thin meshed nets, etc., is, you know, colossal and immeasurable. So the total cost of this project, I think, is about 15 billion rupees. So MSA can pay back to the country in a matter of a year or two. So I would urge PMSA, you know, that after these ships are inducted, they should immediately, you know, at least stop this menace of illegal fishing in our waters. Pakistan is endowed with huge riches in its maritime sector. You know, we have a coastline spread over 1,000 kilometers. We have an exclusive economic zone 200 nautical miles from our coast, having an area of 240,000 square kilometers, and with the efforts of Navy and the Ministry of Science and Technology, we were able to add another 50,000 square kilometers in this area. And now we have a combined maritime area of close to 300,000 square kilometers, which is more than the combined area of KPK and Punjab. And it is now up to us to harvest this huge treasure of resources that nature has endowed Pakistan with. But unfortunately, we have not even taken the first step in this direction. And if you add CPEC to that, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, there are huge opportunities that are coming our way. I'll give you just one example. You know, Pakistan's total trade is around $70 billion, $50 billion import and $20 billion exports. And China's external trade is $3.5 trillion. And if we are hoping to just capitalize or cash 10% of this trade, you can, you know, do the calculation, and you will come to the figure of $350 billion of trade that will flow through our ports, including Gwadar. So that is about five times the present volume of trade that we are carrying through our ports. And this thing would realize in next 5 to 10 years, inshallah. And by that time, our trade would, you know, increase, Chinese trade would increase, and if you add the trade from Central Asian republics to this figure, so we are looking ahead at shipping activity and maritime activity, which is beyond imagination of, you know, our current generation. So we have to be prepared and take that first step. Unfortunately, we have not been able to harvest the riches of our maritime sector, and I have made this as one of command pillars or one of the pillars of my command vision in the next 3 years. That is to jumpstart the maritime sector. I am not saying revival, because you revive something which has, you know, started and then it has fell dormant, and then you revive it again. Here we have not even taken the first step. So it is very, very important that we jumpstart our maritime sector. And I can tell you that maritime sector has the potential to double or even treble our GDP. And in that, you know, the Navy is the only organization in this country which is the custodian of maritime thought. Unfortunately, we suffer from this often called, you know, disease of sea blindness. Our population centers lie in the hinterland. The political power lies, you know, alongside the GT Road and in the Hazara Belt. And if you talk of Karachi, overpopulated, there are about, I don't know, 20 or 25 National Assembly seats. But from Karachi to Jewani, it is just one National Assembly seat. So you can imagine that there is no political power here, no population centers here. So people are not turning or not paying attention to this dormant sector, this dormant resources, enormous resources that nature has endowed us with. Now this is an opportunity that nature has given us, and unfortunately we are very good at, you know, turning opportunities into liabilities. And liability, by not paying attention to our coast, development of infrastructure, and resultantly we have all our attention at Karachi, and from Karachi to Jewani, the coast is mostly, you know, devoid of any communication infrastructure and development of the coastal tourism, development of ports. Everything is concentrated around Karachi. The second port that we built in 1971, that was also co-located with Karachi. And resultantly, Karachi has exploded, you know, out of its seams. So ladies and gentlemen, I have, you know, taken on this challenge of, you know, jump-starting our maritime sector. And in that, I would urge the support of all sections of the society, and especially my friends from media sitting here. You know, you have to highlight and make the general population, make the decision makers aware of this thing that we have to, you know, start paying attention towards our maritime sector. On Karachi Shipyard, I must congratulate the MD. This shipyard has seen many ups and downs, and the present administration and the last one, they deserve special credit because they brought the shipyard out of red, and now for last many years, shipyard is into profit. And it is holding the mantle of meeting all the shipbuilding needs of Pakistan for last about 70 years. But I can tell you that we need additional shipyards very badly. The nations, you know, around the world who made economic progress took off their economies through shipbuilding industries. You talk of Japan, you talk of South Korea, you could talk of China. They all started their, you know, economies with shipbuilding industry in the 1960s and 70s. In the present era, you know, India has 46 shipyards. Bangladesh, which is separated from us in 1971, has 26 shipyards, small and large. And we are just content with one shipyard. So we need to make additional shipyards. Nature has given us advantage of this, you know, very important geostrategic location. We have, you know, cheap labor. So our efforts are to have immediate, you know, contracts with foreign renowned shipyards, to have at least two shipyards, one at Gwadar and one in Port Qasim, with world renowned, you know, shipyards having joint ventures with them. And in this regard, we have already approached the government, and the summary is lying with the in the office of Prime Minister of Pakistan. But to shipyard, I would say that, you know, they should continue with their efforts. They are the torchbearers. They have the know-how, and they have to, you know, take the lead role in establishing the additional shipyards in this country. And towards the end, you know, I would once again like to congratulate the CSTC for their support in this project, and thank MD Shipyard for inviting me today, and talking to you. Pakistan, China, Dosti, Pak-China friendships, Zindabad, and Pakistan, Paindabad. Thank you.